Hi, thanks for joining me. Today I'm going to show you how to make one of these little albums. I made this for my daughter Brooke. I've still got to finish it, but isn't this cute? Here's the back side. Okay, here's one I made earlier, and here's a couple of them I'm still working on. So we're going to get started. I only have 10 minutes on these tutorials. I'm going to open up your arm of your trimmer. Use your scoring blade. You need a true 12 by 12 sheet of cardstock. If it's short, then it's not going to score right, or it's not going to be in the right spot, okay? So you're going to score this at 3, 6, and 9. And then you're going to turn this and score it in the same measurement. So that's 3, 6, and 9. And this is the inside of the album. Okay, let me get this out of the way. Okay. Just going to fold these over, get those score lines really good. Okay, see, here you go. I've got a little sheet that I made. The dotted lines on here are for the cutting, and so if you need this, I can send it to you. Okay, I can email it to you. I'm going to move my grid paper aside for a second because I'm going to need to cut this with the Hobby Blade and the cutting mat. And the cutting mat this month is actually, if there's a special, if you purchase the cutting mat, you get the blade for free. Now here's the catch. You need to use a ruler that's not wood and that you can't cut. Because I've tried this before and I've accidentally just sliced a little bit of my ruler, okay? So I'm going to take the Hobby Blade, start on the second block, and go all the way. Well, and see, if you're not careful what you're doing, you could even cut the plastic rulers. And I didn't get it. Let's try again. Rewind. I wish I had a rewind button on there, but I don't. But I think it's good for you guys to see these mistakes. See, look, I didn't really mess up anything. Okay, so you're going to turn it. Okay, hopefully I didn't get anybody off track there with my messing up. You're going to start again. The second line. See, I shouldn't talk when I'm cutting. There we go. And turn it again. Every time I'm starting on the second block and then cutting all the way down. Okay? There we go. Okay, see, it kind of looks like I messed up, but I didn't. What you're going to do is fold these. See how easy this is? And this is the inside of my album. Isn't that neat? Okay, so now we're going to work on the cover. I'm going to put my grid paper back here. This time I'm going to use the Ginger Blossoms designer paper. I have someone in mind for this one. Okay. So what I'm going to do is take my cardboard pieces, or you could use chipboard. These pieces measure 3 1/4 by 3 1/4, okay? And I'm putting the adhesive actually on the cardboard. And if you were making this as a gift and you were going to put a lot of pictures in here, you might want to use sticky strip, okay? Because the snail probably would have a hard time holding a bunch of photos. I use a lot on these projects. Okay. You're going to take your scissors now and cut. And don't cut it all the way to the point. You need to leave just a little bit so that it can fold over the point. Go ahead and take your bone folder, let me get these out of the way, and go ahead and get your score lines there. That way, this will fold over much easier, okay? Whoops. Okay, again, take your bone folder, fold these over. Bone folder helps Okay, then you're going to use your adhesive. Again, I would use the sticky strip on these. Okay. What this kind of does is it kind of rounds the edges. If you used your fingers, you could either tear it a little bit or get it a little dirty. You can get nail polish on there sometimes. Okay. Okay. See? There's my cover. Perfect. What I'm going to do is line this up on my grid paper. I'm going to put about a half an inch of space in between them. I'm going to lay my ribbon right on top, and then I'm going to put adhesive actually on the ribbon. Okay, we'll straighten this back out again. This was my way of figuring out how to get the ribbon on there straight, is just line these up with the grid paper and then flip your ribbon right over. See? Okay, so now I'm going to take the inside and I'm going to put some adhesive on here. I'm just moving this grid paper every which way. Okay, so then you just open it up and don't put it to the edge. See? Now I'm going to put the adhesive on. Again, I would use sticky strip. I'm showing you this today with snail, but this is pretty bulky. I would use the sticky strip. Okay, so instead of just flipping it over, I like to just pick it up and try to align the cardboard instead of that white piece, because then to me that it's better to line the cardboard. Okay, now I'm going to open it up and show you. See? Look at the back side. Okay, again. Now what this does is technically it would fold out like this. So what I would do is actually staple a couple of these, or what I plan on doing is putting some adhesive here and putting a little tag with a ribbon at the top. Isn't that cute? Okay. If you have any questions, let me know. Thanks a lot.